Soaring across the night sky, above the azure sea, we see the Skynomad gleam through dark clouds with another airship in hot pursuit. Captain Rayleigh turns hard on the ship's wheel, and with a loud moaning creak, the Skynomad swiftly changes its course, and barely avoids a volley of cannonballs fired from the other airship. As Rayleigh straightens the Skynomad's course, First Mate Shelby waltzes over to the stern and raises his blue coral staff. Bright light gathers at the tip, and Shelby fires an eldritch blast towards the enemy ship. The blast connects with a cannon, which in turn explodes in a plume of fire and smoke.
Sartre, do your dragon thing now! Captain Rayleigh shouts. Bomb, Rotary, Wilmer, get on the back and board those motherfuckers.
With a quick but nervous gait, Sartre walks to the center of the upper deck. The other crew members give her ample space as she places both her hands on the deck and shakes her head from side to side. Silver scales replace her skin, and her humanoid figure expands until she becomes a silver dragon. The three other warriors equip their gear and in swift unison climb up to Adra's back. Captain Rayleigh smirks before facing Shelby. First Mate Shelby and Narad, be sure to give them covering fire. The Toll doesn't have time to respond, as a cannonball hits the starboard of the Skynomad and deadly shrapnel is flung across his deck, hitting Shelby on his right side while Captain Rayleigh's left arm is pierced by a fragment. However, both are immediately tended to by respectively Quorp and Insunu, who administer their wounds with healing spells. Captain Rayleigh steadies herself and grabs hold of the ship's wheel once more.
Good job, Insunu. Be sure to send anyone too hurt to find down to Dr. Talon. Nobody dies today. Not while I'm in command.
That's a backs of power and nods.
Aye, Captain.
Her voice is nearly drowned as Sir Adra let loose a thunderous roar and leaps off the airship with a strong gust of wind as she flaps her powerful wings. With a calm smile on his face, Shelby looks to the remaining crew of the Skynomad.
Don't worry, you guys and girls. Everything is hunky-dory. Thunderous and Andy, kindly man the cannons and aim it at the hull beneath the enemy's mast. If we are lucky, we will hit the floating core, which will send the ship and its crew to an early watery grave.
Suddenly, there's a creeping silence in the Skynomad. It is not from the lack of gunfire or spells being cast. It is from the realization that several high-pitched cries can be heard. At first, nothing else seems to happen. But then Bonrus points into the sky towards the northeast and yells,
"Wyverns!"
Appearing behind a heavy cloud, emerge five wyverns with lizardfolk riders. Each rider throws spears down at the crew on the Skynomad, but they are fortunately intercepted by Quorp as he erects a magic barrier. The ordeal, however, proves to be quite tasking as the tiefling falls to his knees and pants as beads of sweat forms on his brow.
Captain, if I may?
Captain Ryder sends a stern glare over her shoulder. What do you want, prisoner? The necromancer Calibrite scoffs, but otherwise remains stoic.
Well, seeing as my safety relies upon the safety of your ship and crew, I would like to offer my services.
Fuck off, and get back to the brig, or I'll toss you off this ship. Calibrite forces Captain Ryder to stare into the dark eyes.
I get it. You don't like me. Big bloody surprise. Nobody does, nor ever will. And I will never care about that. But I don't have the fucking luxury to let your emotions cloud your judgment. Right now, all that you and your crew have managed to do is keep the enemy at bay. But if I don't help, we will die.
Captain Ryan falls silent and grits her teeth. But after a pregnant pause, she finally says,
Fine. How are you gonna help?
Calibrite points towards one of the women's.
Bring me the corpse of that one, as intact as possible. The sooner the better.
Rayleigh shakes her head and sighs.
Listen up. Focus fire on the women 12 o'clock. Refrain from excessive damage.
That is an order. Get to it.
The Skynomad creaks once more as it sets course directly towards the women in front of the bow. The airship slowly descends as ballista bolts, cannonballs or spells are unleashed upon the beast. The lizardfolk rider tries to do a barrel roll in order to avoid the volley, but he is struck in the head by a blast by Shelby and with a terrified scream flies off his steed and plummets towards the sea several hundred feet below. The wyvern roars in excruciating pain as it is unable to escape its imminent doom. In anticipation of its death, Captain Riley steadies the Sky Nomad and in the nick of time manages to place the airship right underneath the descending Wyvern, which lands with a heavy thump on the deck, sending tremors across the ship. Calibrite doesn't hesitate for a single moment. She rushes to the corpse and with her right hand removes the cloth that covers her left arm. She bites down into the stump where her left hand used to be until blood drips violently from the wound. She then stabs her bloody arm into the wound at the Wyvern's heart. With her right hand, Calibrite makes a gesture in the air as if she's gasping the heart of the Wyvern. With a sudden, erratic movement, she clenches her fist and let go. Once. Twice. Thrice. Nothing happens. But the fourth time, the body of the Wyvern begins to emit crimson mist, and the flesh peels off. With a staggering movement, the skeleton of the Wyvern gets up, leaving behind its mortal coil in a pool of thick sludge. It opens its maw as if to roar, but no sound can be heard.
Gods be damned, Captain Riley utters to herself. I hope this doesn't come back to bite me in my ass, or I swear I will repeatedly stab in her dumb face.
Calibrite gets up from the deck and places her hand in the air. The skeletal Wyvern bends down and rests its cranium on her palm.
Kill the riders, chase off the Wyverns. Now go, my darling. Save us all.
The Wyvern nods, and defying the laws of gravity, it flies into the air, producing a trail of crimson fog in its wake.
I like our odds better already, Calibrite says as she walks up to Captain Riley.
Well, at least one of us do.